Well, John, thank you for joining me. You've been honoured and awarded with the club president title of Port Vale Football Club. This must be not only a proud day for yourself, but for your family as well.
That's correct. Obviously, Port Vale means such a lot to me. I'm very proud and honoured to be asked to be the and take this role on. I don't exactly know 100% what it actually entails, but I mean, it'll be more or less the same as what I've been doing since I've been back in the last 18 months or so. So, I'm really proud and honoured to actually take the role of president of the club. As I say, I'm not sure I'll be still continuing going to try and help John Askey as I did trying to help Neil Aspin. And sort of that's been looking at games, sort of watching the match, being all here, representing the club at home and away. And so, yes, we'll just have to see, you know, how that pans out, but it's a great honour.
How much does this club mean to you? You've got plenty of experience here, you've managed here and you came back as a football advisor, and you've got a real special bond with the fans as well. How much does it mean to you?
Massive. You know, I think it's a massive part of my life. I've been very fortunate. I've been in football for, 60 years now. And so it's been here for 20. And then moving on to Stoke, whatever, I've been lucky to have been part and parcel of both clubs in the city, which I'm proud of. But Port Vale was the main one for me when I was the assistant manager to start with and then taking over manager. And for the success that we had in there, it's fantastic memories, not only for me, but also for the supporters. You know, we managed to get, three promotions in that time, you know, three Wembley visits, and also signed a lot of very good players we had in that time. Times change now, but I mean, the thing is that I've got fantastic memories of this club, and it means so much to me.
What are your fondest memories of this club? As you mentioned there, a few promotions, a few Wembley appearances, ones that spring to mind for me, and I think many of the fans, was that 1993 Autoglass Trophy win. What stands out for you?
Well, that was the first time, obviously, the club had been to Wembley, and that was a fantastic time. We didn't win that game, which was unfortunate. We did win that game, but we didn't win the next one, which is the more important one, when we went back to Wembley again and lost to West Brom. So that was a disappointment in time, but it was great to go to Wembley. The first time that the club had been there, the supporters were fantastic in that respect. But overall, I mean, it's been a really great sort of career that I've had actually at Port Vale, and I'm really proud of the club, and that's why I just came back to see whether I could help.
You've managed over 800 games for Port Vale, and I think you just told me 850 to be specific. When you look through and back on your experience, you've certainly seen the lows that the club's had to endure and the highs that the club's had to go through. And can you feel that change in the times now, a positive future for the club under this new era of Carroll and Kevin Shanahan?
Well, we certainly hope so. I mean, when I arrived here with John McGrath, we're talking about 79, we're talking about then that Port Vale were more or less bottom of the fourth division. And sort of as time went by, we managed to get into the championship and have some great, fantastic games, you know, against top teams. Not only just doing well in the league, but also in the FA Cup, we did exceptionally well. And so they're great memories for me, but also for the supporters as well. And obviously it's a different era now. It's not the same, there's no question about that. I mean, I can just imagine the first signing I made was one of my first ones was Andy Jones for £3,000 from Rill. I mean, that'd be £300,000 now. But what we did then, he did exceptionally well for us in the situation. We sold him for £350,000. And that gave me the opportunity then to go and buy two or three better players who had played in the higher level league. Mills, Gary Ford, all those players came in and started improving the team. It's difficult and different now. You know, there's a lot of the Premier League sides now are going and buying international foreign players now. They're not coming to the lower divisions very often. I mean, Gareth Ainsworth, I bought for £500,000, sold him for £2 million within 18 months. You know, will that happen again? You know, regarding sort of the lower divisions, you know, because the top teams now are going right onto the continent and getting players from in there. So it doesn't give the opportunity for the lower league players to advance and get into the Premier League. But I mean, that's like everything else in life, everything changes. It's just great for me to still be involved in football after, you know, at my age. I'm getting on a little bit now, but I mean, the thing is that I still enjoy being involved actually in Port Vale Football Club, and to be honoured with this president role, as well as what I do as well. I'm here more or less every day of the week, it is a proud and great honour for me to actually fill that berth.
And you certainly keep yourself involved. As you said there, you come in each day, but you don't just sit in the office behind a computer. You're down at training, you're giving players advice, and you're helping John Askew down at the training ground. Does that keep you going, the fact that you know you're around that football environment and you can still help out in that sense?
Well, that's it. I mean, I've said to him, and I did say the same thing to Neil Aspin and John as well. It's their time now, not mine. You know, and there's a situation that whatever I can do to help them, okay, I'm only too grateful to try and do that and try and see if we can get the club back up on a much more favourable manner than it is now. And our two owners now in the situation is that I think there's a fantastic good feel about the club at the moment in time. But obviously that will only enhance if you start just winning some games on the football field, and that's what the supporters want. They want us to see whether we can do a lot better than they've done the last couple of years. And that's what John Askew's trying and striving to do now.
Just talking about the supporters there, what is it about that bond that you have with them? Not a lot of people can work at both clubs in the city and still be as popular and as, you know, rewarded and honoured as you are by the fans. What is it about the fans that you love? What is that relationship?
Oh, I'm very grateful for that in a situation that obviously I've served both clubs, but the Port Vale era when I was here for 20 years and the success we had, that stands out for me as the most important thing probably in my football career. You know, I was a player, I was an average player, I played in the Championship as well, but to do what we did at Port Vale in those years, and to have the success we did, it means such a great great amount to me, and also to the supporters. And I'm very grateful that the supporters still remember it, you know? And so, it does mean a great deal to me. And sort of, if I can help to try and put the club back on that forward moving thing to get more success, then obviously it'd be a fantastic time for me.
I'm sure you know who said this, but I'm going to read a quote to you. Every Vale supporter should get down on their knees and thank the Lord for John Rudge. Do you know who said that?
I do. That's Alex Ferguson. No, I had an exceptionally good relationship with Alex. he was the pinnacle of any football manager, and he was very helpful for me. I remember, and I think that he'd been at Manchester United for 25 years, and there was a dinner, and he invited me and my wife up to the dinner. And he came and speaking after everybody had eaten the food, and I was sitting on a table where a lot of his Manchester United players, ex-players, were there. And he was talking, and he says, there's Rudgy there. He says, oh, he says, he used to ring me up, he says, and by the time I'd put the phone down, he says, I was in tears. He says, he used to say, Alex, I've not got any money. But I said, can you help me? You know, whatever, but you know, I've got nothing, no money to spend, and sort of, and so he was tremendous for me, and helped me a great deal. And obviously his advice and whatever was a big part to play in my career.
Well, John, congratulations once again from everyone at Port Vale Football Club, and the best of luck in the many years, and hopefully you can see the more positive years in the years to come at Port Vale.
We certainly hope so. I just hope we can have a little bit more success this year. I think that, as I said, that Carl and Kevin have brought this good feeling into the club, but we've got to be a little bit patient. You know, I mean, the thing is, if we could sort of just have the improvement this season and sort of build and see if we can start to do it, as I did, from the bottom of the fourth division, it wasn't instant success. It was a situation where we gradually got better, and let's hope that the club really gets that successful period again, and also the supporters come and support us like they did for me and like they've always done for me, which I'm very, very grateful for. It's a big part of my life.